party in bullshit. All I wanna do. This party is too lit. To leave, I done bought the bus, I'm by the bed to take my keys. Turned up to the D, shouted looking right at me. Told her I'm a rich boy, I'm about to throw some D's. These bitches only love you for the person that they see. Why you think I keep these BBS's all on me? All I wanna do is party and bullshit.
Hey, we back, we black. It's party bullshit, y'all. Let's not. To my right, yo left, yo, he's the first comic that I ever seen when I was inside New York and whatnot. He's doing his thing right now, and as for years and shit, he's traveling the country. He writes for everybody, and I like to call him the Underground Railroad to for comedians that new niggas. Y'all give it up for the one and only Joe Show. Now to my left, yo right, she's a writer, artist, singer, personality, relationship guru. It worked just for her relationship, but yeah, she know what she's talking about. Because it's her life. Y'all give up the one and only Phoenix.
Hey!
That's good, y'all. What's up, baby?
What is going on, Jack Thriller? I'm appreciative of being here. Thank you for having me.
Man, yo, it's a pleasure and honor to have you, man.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. So, you know, let's get right to it, man. Yo, you're an artist. You've been writing. You ain't a stranger to the game. You wrote for many people over the years.
Yes, I went from a songwriter to a background singer to an artist, and now as a singer, a rapper. Now I've been actually booking a lot of gigs as a hip hop artist, which is surreal.
But explain that transition right there, and when it started working. What did you say, and why did you think it was necessary to do it, and what was the moment? What was the moment like? Oh shit, they responded more to rap.
Right.
Because some of us don't know what the switch is.
Right.
Oh, this is working. Let me go over here.
Right. So I was working on an EP that I actually didn't release. But on the project, I didn't have a lot of writers involved because I've been a songwriter for so long. But I never wanted to be that writer who thought, I'm so dope, I can never work with nobody else. Because I feel like that's the downfall of a lot of artists, not opening their horizons and letting people challenge them in their artistry. So I have a friend named Munchie who's an amazing writer. At that time, she wasn't feeling inspired, and I wanted to encourage her to keep writing. So I said, I'm going to send you this fire ass track. I had this producer randomly hit me up, and she wrote me a rap record. Now, she knew I could rap for myself, but that was her way of encouraging me to do it. So I kind of wrote the hook, and I wrote the pre-chorus, but she wrote the rhymes, and I was like, I can't release this record first, and I don't write anything, because I need people to know that I can actually do it on my own, but I'm smart enough to know a good record and still record the record. So I started putting out freestyles. I made Afropunk 2016. I made it again last year, but I made it for the hip-hop record. So when a platform like Afropunk notices you for something like that, it's like, you know what I mean? Because I know that the person that picks those artists, he's very particular about the artist. And he don't care about Instagram followers. He don't care about clout.
That's how I feel.
He only cares about if you're good. So when he chose that record, I said, oh, they really checking for this hip-hop shit. Let me, like, keep doing it. So I started releasing freestyles and then I put out a mixtape, and I booked a show in January to open for a really buzzing indie artist named Coda the Friend as a hip-hop artist. And I just kind of been going with the flow. So now in the middle of the fork of the world of like meshing the singer and the rapper together to make it work.
So comedy's been good to me, man, since I met you. Man, you've been holding it down, and I've been writing for everybody. I just did the Apollo, headlined the Apollo.
Give it up for that.
Yeah!
Man, that was big, man. That was big. As an artist, you just wanted to perform at the biggest place in your city, and the Apollo, for our people, is the biggest.
It don't get no bigger. It's not the Barclays.
Yeah, so I just retired. You know, I quit comedy after doing that.
Oh, as you should. I made it. I'm done.
You done made it.
Nah, still more to go. Still more to do. One of my goals is to actually, believe it or not, it sounds weird, but I want to be an announcer at MSG because I'm a huge Knicks fan.
That's not
small. But I want to be the guy.
That's not small at all, bro.
I want to be the guy that says, coming out now. You know what I'm saying? la la la. You know what I'm saying? I want to be that. I don't know none of the players because I ain't watched the Knicks yet. Like,
but you'll learn them. But I'm gonna learn to read that paper.
Hopefully, I'll be like coming out now. Kevin Durant and Kyrie Irving.
Okay. Okay. You trying to get a job next year?
Trying to get a job now. Mm-hmm.
Well, ultimately, what do you want?
Well, like,
do you know?
I do and I don't. What happens is the goal keeps changing. You know, you reach a certain goal, and then when you arrive there, you're like, this was cool, but what else? So, like, what he said with the Apollo, I think that's amazing. I think that's where I'm at right now, just kind of on the, I'm in between the level up. Like, I've accomplished some things. It's like, oh, that's cute, but what else? You know what I mean? And I'm the type of person that I can see that for myself. I don't really need somebody to tell me what else. So I've just been strategically trying to plot my next move and make the smartest move and stop working as hard but work smart. Mm-hmm. So that's really where I'm at. I've been hosting a lot more too. I really enjoy hosting, even though I'm an artist. I guess because I was a songwriter first, I genuinely like to show love to other artists. I genuinely like to encourage other musicians, specifically if you're good. Mm-hmm. And I think you're dope at what you do, because it can be discouraging in this industry a lot of times when quantity overrules quality. Mm-hmm. Yes. So I want to consistently, you know, encourage artists and host events. I just hosted the SOBs a couple of weeks ago. I did BB Kings a couple of years ago. I'm trying to, like, get some residencies and just put myself out there as a brand.
I was telling this girl from my show to go get a residency and create her own thing and whatnot. Yeah, I think that's an excellent idea. And what do you feel like is the difference between hosting and being the person that comes out? Because, you know, all too many times we like, yeah, I'm the main event and blah, blah, blah. But a lot of people don't know that the master of ceremonies
is really
the star of the show.
Okay. Yeah, you set the tone.
And you know what? Hey, yo, Joe Show, what you prefer? Going on first or going on last? All
right, so in the comedy game, you know, audience caught on to it, but usually the person who goes on first is usually the person who either has less experience or is probably not as funny as the other acts. Mm-hmm. But not always, because sometimes you have a show where all three acts or all four acts are as equally as good. But I like going first because they always think that you're not going to kill it.
Me too.
You know what I'm saying? And then when you get out there and kill it, now you a hard act to follow.
Yeah, they're like, oh, man, shit. And that nigga's backstage fighting. You're like, oh, man, you want to go there?
Man, you don't want to go there. They got a standing ovation.
And you go there, that motherfucker be scrambling and shit. Hey, man, hey. I hit him on the shoulder like, I had to do your thing, boy.
They hoping you bomb.
They hoping you bomb.
Like, oh, bomb, so I could go out there and make fun of you and be better. But you go out there and blow it up as the first person that comes out. But I prefer hosting. Mm-hmm. I love doing everything, but I tell you why, hosting, you got the most time on stage.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
You
that's
set
right.
the tone, mm-hmm. and you can do whatever the hell you want to do. It's your show. It's your show. I got some bomb stories.
Let's hear it.
Can you hear it?
Nah, y'all ain't ready for that.
Y'all want
to? I'm gonna tell you anyway. Hey y'all, I got booed at a church.
What?
Yeah.
You
were talking
to
me. I'm sure they
did it like on
good
time.
What?
Don't
you think? I heard that. I know that's right.
Hey, a motherfucker got booed at a church. I was an hour late. They were waiting for me. The pastor was there.
That's
the
first
step. That's the first step. You gotta be on time. Traffic was terrible. Traffic was terrible. It was so bad. When I walked in, one of the church ladies came in my ear and whispered, and she was like, get your fucking ass on stage. I was like, whoa! Whoa! Jesus on the cross. He was like, get your ass on stage. Get your ass on stage. Jesus came in. I got up there and I
and you still bombed.
Hey, you know what? I was like super confident, cocky. I was like, it's a church show. You just gotta be clean and not do anything, any sexual reference, and say amen a lot and say, God is good.
All the time.
Good night, that's my time.
It's simple. You were supposed to win.
I was supposed to win. I was set up by the grace of God, I lost. So I was up there, and I started talking about the first lady of the church. I said, hey, where my young people at? She clapped. I said, ha-ha, not you. I said, young people. And they was like, whoa,
the first lady. My sister Loretta.
My sister Loretta. She like the Michelle Obama of the church. And Beyonce rolled into one.
All into one.
They be serious about that.
They be serious. The first lady, they be serious. All right, all the ushers got up and stood around her.
What are you doing, Joseph? Gospel going.
I started snapping her. I said, I looked at her clothes. I was like, where you got that outfit from? Forever 31.
Oh my God! That's what
savage. I went savage on the first night of the church.
Wow!
I said she shopped at Fashion Under.
Zero.
Man, they was like, boom!
Hey, ho! Turn your Bibles to Matthew 4. Thou shalt not boo a nigga.
And they was like, oh, you said nigga, turn boo. And they kept going. And then, like, after they paid me, I took a portion of the money and I gave it back to church. I went up back on stage and I was like, here's my tithes. And I went back.
It's so out of control.
I went up. Oh, I can't lie about it. I went back on stage and I said, can you guys please donate a portion of this money to any child, any youth movement in this church? And then I said, thank y'all so much. They clapped, and afterwards, they was like, oh, we loved you. Get the fuck out of here. You made me give back half my money. The pastor was like, thank you, young man. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's my bombing story.
Did you ever work in that church again?
Hell no. I'm a burn that church down.
Mississippi burning.
Oh, yeah, God. Man.
You gonna hear the church burning down in Brooklyn.
Okay.
You
gonna show up at your next show.
Have you ever bombed?
Yes.
Tell me your bomb story.
Oh my God.
Bombs over Baghdad.
So in Brooklyn, there's this festival called
Brooklyn is a boo.
Yes.
African
Shoot Festival.
Yes. And I got the opportunity to perform. It wasn't like my original music, but it was like Lauryn Hill, like cover. And I spoke.
You can't do a Lauryn Hill cover at night.
No, I got the voice. That's not the problem.
Hell
yeah. I smoked a blunt before I went on stage and forgot the whole second verse.
No!
And
God.
I was like, I fell off. And then I had a friend in the crowd like, Rafiba, like, by the crowd.
Yes!
It was horrible. And they were just all like, Lauryn Hill? Like, how can we forget?
No.
Lauryn Hill? Oh, hey. I shouldn't have smoked.
Weed and comedy. I don't know. A lot of comedians smoke weed before they perform. I can't.
Something to you.
No, everybody can't. Don't get twisted. It's some niggas that can do it and whatnot. But hey, you even heard see David Chappelle put it in one of his three stand-up specials. That time he smoked, and whatnot.
Oh, yeah,
and he got booed.
His biggest bomb.
His biggest fucking bomb in Detroit.
Smoking
with a rapper.
Smoking with a.
Because you don't know what these niggas be smoking. They said it was loud, but what's some shit over loud? You can't even hear. And if you can't hear yourself, how you gonna do what the fuck you got to do?
Oh,
I did a battle rap event. And you can go watch this shit. When it's a classic one too.
Wait, I'm
like, there's a classic one. I'm hosting this shit.
Oh, okay.
I host this shit. That Olu with that. Loaded Lux versus Hollow the Dungeon.
This
is a classic. I'm the host.
I got okay.
And I lost my voice because I was drinking. So and this is because before I started doing my hosting and whatnot, I was taking these shots. I can't drink hard shit before shows, and I was doing Patron shot triples and shit till I lost my voice.
Wow.
I wasn't drunk. I lost my voice, and I was doing like, I come to this day now, give me Lord.
Damn.
Wow.
I gotta eat up
some
vocal cords.
You can see all this shit as I'm introducing these motherfuckers.
Wow. I had one job.
Wow.
One job. And I was, like I said, I was coherent, but I didn't drink my throat out. This shit didn't burn my whole throat out. And I fucked this shit up. And it is a class. The niggas got me in battle rap Jeopardy. And who is the worst host of all time? One, Smack. B, Jack Thriller. Three, Chuck Willery. Yeah, they got me. Yeah, that's how. Oh, hold on. It's some other shit I had did too. This wasn't even about drinking, it was about something like, hey, so I know y'all got some more famous shit to do, man. We ain't gonna hold y'all up, man. Thank y'all for coming to Party and Bullshit. Is there anything y'all want to tell the people before we get about you?
Alright, so I'm gonna be on Kenan Thompson tour. I got some
That sound like a whole lot of new money.
Right.
That nigga's cool.
Sure is. Also too, I got one of the longest running comedy shows in New York Monday at a spot called Island Taste in Rosedale, Queens. If you ever been to
Rosedale,
yeah.
They got some jerk chicken over there?
Jerk chicken, Rasta.
Okay.
Monday night, since me, Thursday I'm with Fabian the barber and Gavin, Foxy Brown's brother, at a spot called Brooklyn Prime. We do a show there with AG White, the great AG White, every Thursday. And then man, you can catch me on my Instagram doing all types of famous stuff with Jack, man.
Boom, there it is. There you go. Phoenix.
Yes, well, talk to him. You can catch me, Jack, and Michelle on the new season of It at the Table this summer coming up soon.
Nice.
I wanted to shout that out. I also want you to hit me up on Instagram. Book me. I'm a really dope host and artist. I'm a songwriter as well. So if you need somebody to help you tighten up your shit, I'm your girl. Holla at me. I'm not bougie. At least not yet.
Party of bullshit. I take some pictures, y'all.